students, today we are going to study here in our this regular math textbook in this measurement chapter. See this page number 41, last one point remain, measurement volume and capacity. These are some vessels full of water. You see this picture here, some different type of these vessels, and all these vessels full of water. Observe them and tell which ones can hold more water and which one can hold this less water. You observe this and see which vessel hold more water and which vessel hold less water. See this here, this last one vessel, you see this vessel hold here more water, and this vessel, see this first one, this vessel hold here less water. The bucket will hold the most water, and this bowl, see this bowl, the least, no, this one bowl is the least water. See this picture, first one, this bucket became full when 40 glasses of water were poured in it. You see this first one picture here, this bucket became full when this, you see this glass. This one glass is 40 glasses of water. This 40 glasses of water were poured in it. Then second one, see this bucket became full with these 10 pitchers of water. This bucket become full only these 10 pitchers of this water. The same amount of water measure says different because different means are used to here measure it. Then no matter who fills water in the bucket, it should measure the same. For that we must use a standard measure. This is a measure of this 1 liter. You see this unit of this measure here, 1 liter. The milkman keep this 1 liter, this measurement milkman keep this. It is used to measure the out liquid such as milk and oil. We can easily get a 1 liter water bottle. See this bottle is 1 liter bottle. The picture alongside shows a measure used especially for this kerosene. This also 1 liter, but this used for this kerosene, and this used for this oil or milk. The liter is a standard unit for measuring liquids. The unit is the liter. The liter is a standard unit for this measuring liquids. Take various vessels such as a pitcher, a box, a pan, etc., and make an estimate how much water they can hold. 1 liter, less than 1 liter, more than 1 liter. Verify your guess by actually using a 1 liter bottle. You do activity in home. You take here various types of the vessels. Then you see in a pan, in a box, and you make a estimate of this how much water can be hold, means 1 liter, yeah, less than 1 liter, more than 1 liter. See next one, page number 42. See here different types of these vessels. You see this, pour here 3 liters of water in each of these above containers. You pour here in each vessel here 3 liters of water. The water will take a different shape in each container because each container is of a different shape. But the volume of water in each container is only 3 liters. You see here, this each container here is a different shape. This all these containers are the same? No. Each container is here this different shape, and both the volume of water in each container is the 3 liter. 5 1-liter bottle of water were poured in this bucket, and the volume of the water in the bucket is 5 liter. See here, this 5 1-liter bottles of this water were poured in this bucket. Then this volume of this bucket is 5 liter. This volume of this bucket is 5 liter. Find out how much more water can be added to fill this bucket completely. This bucket can hold 12 liters of water. Here in this bucket here pour only 5 liters of water, but actually this bucket can hold here 12 liters of water. It means that the capacity of this bucket, the capacity of this bucket is how much? 12 liters. The amount of water that is needed to fill any container such as a pot, bucket or a drum or a pan is called as the capacity of the container. The amount of water that is needed to fill in this container such as a pot, bucket, drum, this drum or a pan, and it is called as this capacity of the container. Then take a bottle with a quarter liter capacity. Using this measure, mark the following measures as a container: 2 liters, half a liter, 1.5 liter, a quarter liter. Then see here in note how many liters of water you use for the following purposes in your house. You see in your house how many liters of water you used in daily. See first one here, bathing. In bathing we use how many liter of water, suppose 20 liter, 25 liter, 30 liter. Then next one, washing kitchen utensils. Washing kitchen utensils you use daily 15 and 20 liter of water. Brushing teeth you use only 1 liter of water. Then mopping the floors, you know, mopping these floors we use here this 5 liters of water. Drinking in one day, we drinking here 5 to 6 liter of water. Then watering the garden we use here this more water, means you write here suppose 30 to 35 liter of water. Cooking, in cooking we use here suppose 5 to 10 liter of water. Making 10 cups of tea, then you use here half liter of water. Then washing vehicles, you know, washing vehicles how much of water you use here. Washing vehicles we use here this 35 to 40 liter of water. Make a list of all those places where water is wasted. Make an estimate how of water is wasted and suggest ways of this reducing the wastage. This activity you do here, make a list of all these places where water is wastage. Then you write here this place name. Here you are this regular math textbook, this measurement chapter completed. Okay, bye.